when you begin being an actor, you know, when you're a young actor, there's a natural learning curve of that feeling, of that, like, what is it to be, where do I put my hands, you know, like, just being in your own skin kind of thing. So there is a general feeling of that, that as you gain more experience, that just naturally, that comfortability starts to happen. I think our tendency, especially as younger actors, is we want to do something to the script. What can I do to this to, like, put it into my comfort zone or make it more in the wheelhouse of what I feel cool with? But it's really not our job description. Our job description is, what is this, you know, okay, Rudy, see, all I have is questions, and that's all you should have, even right through the run or right through the film or whatever. This is a completely new being, and you have to shake the etch-a-sketch of who you are to an extent where this new person can be allowed to have free rein and do what he or she needs to do, and that'll all be in the script. So instead of doing something to the script, you allow the script to do something to you. I really, honestly, you know, fundamentally believe that every actor is a character actor, because every role that you ever pick up is going to be not you. It's going to be a character. In fact, the hardest role you'd ever play is playing you in the biopic of your own life, because it would predicate that you would have to know so much more about yourself than you actually know. In a way, it has less to do with you. In a way, you can kind of like back off and let him, I mean, when it's working the best, it'll feel like he or she is playing you. That you're not in there. It's a difference between, look at this, look, I kind of got all the attitude, and I'm kind of like, it's not puppetry. You want this to somehow like alien be inside of you, you know what I mean? So it's not at this manipulated distance. It's something where those responses and that worldview is unbidden. It's in you. When you meet a character for the first time, it's like a man and a woman destined to become lovers meeting for the first time. There's a lot of information that's exchanged there, you know, where, you know, every smell and texture and look and everything is there. And that information, it's like a still pond, okay, that you take that first reading and you drop that first pebble of curiosity down into that pond, and you're gonna chase those ripples that pond makes out for the rest of rehearsal and for the rest of the life and the run of that character. Do you feel alive in a scene? Are you galvanized with your scene partner? Are you getting what you want? You know, like, you know, it's all that one, it's all that 101 bears repeating actor stuff, you know, and it will never change. You know, your toolbox will change. So you're here at the Academy and you've been given a few tools in there, and over the course of your career, they'll change, you know, like you'll go, some tools you'll look at and go, God, I've been using this all wrong for years, and I suddenly now know what this tool does, and you'll lo and behold, you'll use it. Some other ones you'll go, I've never known what that is, so you don't use it. And it becomes a molded kind of thing, where you get a job, and then you stand and look up the mountain of, hopefully scared out of your mind, going, I don't know, how the hell am I gonna do this? And you look down in your toolbox and you go, well, what am I gonna need? Like, that's a good place to be. Now, we're not rocket scientists or brain surgeons, but in a way, we do surgery on a brain. You know, when George and Martha and a bunch of people come into a dark room, they're not gonna watch CNN, or they've elected to go into a dark room, pay the babysitter, pay the parking, and sit shoulder to shoulder with a group of strangers in the dark. That's like a dream world. And then something's gonna happen that hopefully is gonna send them back into their real lives with new information, with a, God, they went through something that I didn't think I could be brave enough to go through. And oh my God, if they can do it, maybe I can do it. That's holding the mirror up to man, as Shakespeare says. That's fulfilling the function. That's what we do as actors, you know. We're not salesmen. This is how much I love storytelling. This is how much I love being in. This is how important I think it is, and that's what should front load every rehearsal, every take, every opportunity to be in a school like this. Like I say, if I didn't have that passion anymore, it would be time to walk away. And not for me, but for it.